The sun rises over one of the world's great horse breeding empires. These snow-covered paddocks are not in Europe or America, they're in Hokkaido, Japan. A country of ancient traditions and cutting-edge modern technology. A world leader famed for its cars, cuisine and the thoroughbred racehorse.
Delta Blues fighting back. Delta Blues, Pop Rock. Delta Blues wins the cup of nose to Pop Rock.
Victoire Pisa in front and wins for Japan. Victoire Pisa
out in front. The Prix d'Espahan has absolutely annihilated the field. Ashin Hikari wins the d'Espahan.
And Myrecki raced up to Rising Romance. They come to the line. And Myrecki in the last stride beat Rising Romance, a photo third.
Since the turn of the century, Japanese horses have won the biggest races in every corner of the globe. Hong Kong, Dubai, Europe, America, and Australia. Every major centre of racing has felt the force of Japanese raiders.
And Morris, what a champion, wins the cup!
Yet just 40 years ago, Japan was considered an isolated outpost of unknown pedigrees and inferior horses. How has this nation risen so far, so fast? The earliest records of horse racing in Japan date back to the 8th century, when the royal family put its best horses to the test. In the 1860s, modern racing arrived through British immigrants and took hold. Racing continued to flourish through the 20th century, and in 1981, Japan decided to test its strength, inviting the world's best horses to race for a huge purse in the Japan Cup. But for the locals, things didn't quite go to plan.
The first running of the Japan Cup, that was, you know, very first international race organized in this country. It was the first running of Japan Cup. Our representatives, Japanese representatives, are the winner of the Emperor's Cup, winner of the Japanese Derby, winner of Arimakinen. Very, very top our horses. But those, the best Japanese horses, were well beaten by the foreign raiders, like a G3 winner from the United States, or this kind of the horses, you know, are much, much stronger than Japanese top horses.
International visitors from the USA, Ireland, England and France all claimed early runnings of the Japan Cup before the New Zealander Horlicks saluted in 1989. The following year, the cup was claimed by Australia after a brilliant final burst from Better Loosen Up.
These Better Loosen Up in the middle is coming with a magnificent run. Kakawi, these Better Loosen Up and Ode. Better Loosen Up in the middle's put his head in front. Better Loosen Up has won for Australia.
We wanted to expose the horse against the best in the world. It was the richest race in the world, and the best horses from everywhere were going there. So we thought he was the best, and thankfully he proved it. We didn't know a lot about Japanese horses at that stage, but they were buying all the best broodmares and bloodlines in the world. When we got there, the enthusiasm for the race and racing in Japan just took us all back. I think it was 156,000 people at the meeting. The betting turnover was huge, and the times the horses were running were just incredible.
In its first 11 years, Japanese horses won the Japan Cup just twice. While national pride suffered a blow, the pain of defeat forged a determination that would soon reap rewards.
All of us involving horse racing and breeding in Japan were very shocked to know, wow, our horses are such a slow. Then everybody, you know, owners, trainers, breeders, and organizers, I mean the Japan Racing Association, determined we have to improve the quality of the racing, quality of the Japanese horses. And everything started from that year, 1981.
Coming up, how Japan's first family of racing single-handedly raised the standard of Japanese bloodstock and the super stallion that put the rest of the world on notice. On Japan's northern island of Hokkaido, one family was already playing its part in lifting the standard of local horses. Master horseman Zenya Yoshida and his three sons, Teruya, Katsumi and Haruya, were investing in the best international bloodlines.
I think the dominance by the Yoshida family, or Shadai Farm, started in 1970, when Northern Taste became the leading sire in this country. So since then, Yoshida dominance has been lasting now 40 years now.
The great winning son of Northern Dancer in Japan. At that time, it was sensational. The world's most fabulous pedigree stallion is standing in Japan.
Northern Taste was the leading sire in Japan an astonishing 11 times through the 80s and early 90s and was considered Japan's greatest ever sire. That title, however, didn't last long, as another stallion was soon to emerge and turn Japanese breeding on its head.
And here comes Sunday Silence through this print, coming to the finish of the Derby. Sunday Silence wins this Derby by 2 lengths.
Sunday Silence was a Kentucky Derby winner, purchased by Zenya Yoshida and imported to Japan. Despite his impressive racing credentials, his breeding career got off to a shaky start.
First impression by breeders in Japan was not very good, because, you know, it's a very famous story that Sunday Silence is not very correct horse. His knee or stifle slightly, you know, shape is slightly funny. So many breeders at the first stallion parade, the breeders said, what a funny leg he has. So first of all, you know, he was not very, very popular in Japan. But once his crop started to run, it was amazing.
Sunday Silence was a stallion whose first two-year-old crop running in Japan won so many listed and group races. It was then that everyone began to believe that he was a special stallion. People soon began to realize that he was a different type of stallion not seen before in Japan.
When Sunday Silence horses start to run in Japan, he dominated all big races. Not only Sunday Silence son or daughter winning the race, second and third, all by Sunday Silence. So people are very much shocked.
One of the speciality by the Sunday Silence influence is turn of foot. Acceleration. You know, in Japan, going up the track is quite quick and fast. So turn of foot is very important to win the racing in this country. So most of the Sunday Silence progeny had this kind of, you know, turn of foot. So then, era of Sunday Silence came, and Sunday Silence was leading sire in Japan for 13 years in a row. Of course, this is the record.
Sunday Silence produced such a remarkable run of results that international breeders started to take notice. One of the first to recognise his potential as a breed-shaping stallion was Arrowfield Stud in Australia.
First of all, he was an outcross for Australian bloodlines, but most importantly, he was a super dominant stallion, and I could tell that from the figures. His strike rate of elite horses to number of runners was very high by world standards. Of course, you've got to understand that in Japan, the number of stakes races in relation to the number of races run is very low. And so to get the sort of figures he was getting indicated to me he was going to be a very dominant stallion, and we wanted to be part of the action. So we sent some mares to Japan to be covered by him and brought them back in foal to Australia.
Those foals proved extremely popular, averaging almost $1 million at yearling sales in Australia. One of them was Sunday Joy, which won the Group 1 Australian Oaks and, as a broodmare, produced eight-time Group 1 winner More Joyous.
More Joyous is going down to the post to win the Queen Elizabeth in a canter.
We have a long and good relationship with Arrowfield, and I wasn't surprised when John Massara contacted us about sending mares to Sunday Silence. I believe John thought that he was a very good stallion And in this game, a good horse is a good horse, no matter where it is in the world.
We could see that Japan was rising like a phoenix out of the ground as a breeding nation and a racing nation. And so we felt it would be a good thing for us to join together, perhaps to open up Australia for them and for them to open up Japan to us.
Fueled by Sunday Silence, Japanese horses were starting to make a mark internationally. An early indicator came at the 2001 Hong Kong International Race Day, where his son Stay Gold was one of three winners for Japan.
Stay Gold's lifting, Ekra's stopping, Stay Gold lunges and wins! Yataka wins the prize!
Another significant breakthrough came in 2005 when Cesario, a granddaughter of Sunday Silence, became the first Japanese horse to claim a Grade 1 race in America.
But no way does she catch the winner, Cesario!
I mean, this is a rare sight for American fans to see one of the best Japanese jockeys and the best three-year-old filly in Japan. And look, had the Japanese press just crowd to see her.
This is a statement they've been trying to make.
Statement, exactly.
It's an international statement about the importance of this race and about how the Japanese industry want to make an impact on US racing.
In that same year, another son of Sunday Silence was taking Japanese racing by storm. Deep Impact swept all before him en route to Japan's Triple Crown for three-year-olds and quickly became a national hero.
Deep Impact was called Horse Has the Wing. You know, he's, you know, horse can fly. His running style was astonishing. You know, he always come from far behind. And okay, let's say three falun pole, or sometime two falun pole, you taka-taka, press the button. Then, Deep Impact, phew, started to fly and, you know, overtake every his rivals. You know, this running style was very dramatic, and people, you know, are excited to see his, you know, late kick, you know, turn of foot on, you know, final part of the race. So this racing style, you know, made him more popular.
I believe his strongest win was his last start in the Arima Kinen, when he came from last, swept around the field very wide on the final corner, hitting the lead to stay on and win easily. That was his last start and left a very strong impression.
Deep Impact's success was bittersweet for Katsumi Yoshida, who bred the horse, then sold him as a yearling. At the end of his brilliant race career, the Yoshida brothers bought him back for a record sum. That high-risk move reaped a huge reward, as Deep Impact proved equally impressive as a sire.
He won so many races himself and became popular. Everyone was then looking forward to see how his progeny would perform. When they two started, winning everything, he became a very popular stallion that everybody wanted to use. He set a new record last season with 37 stakes winners. That's why he's so popular, because he produces quality horses.
Deep Impact, like Sunday Silence and Northern Taste before him, stands at Shadai Stallion Station. When Zenya Yoshida passed away, he left control of the stallion operation jointly to his three sons. Now Shadai Stallion Station is home to more than 30 of Japan's best stallions. Its dominance over the local breeding industry unparalleled in any major racing nation.
Honestly, the main reason of success is due to Zenya Yoshida and now his sons Teruya, Katsumi and Haruya. I believe it is similar to Arrowfield's success being based around John Messara. The success comes from these people building their life on horses. To give you an example, Mr. Katsumi Yoshida, regardless of how busy he is out at track work watching horses work every morning. Until the age of 60, I never saw him take a normal overseas trip that wasn't for horse business. He goes to where horses are. That is his life, and Zenya was the same. And that is where the success comes from.
At Shaddai Stallion Station, the stallions are treated like royalty. Exercised, groomed, and prepared for stud duty with incredible attention to detail. But there is no doubt who the king of this castle is. Deep Impact commands his own bodyguard, and with a service fee of $350,000, he is the most valuable stallion in the world.
From the body type point of view, Deep Impact is a smaller horse compared to Sunday Silence. In regards to results, I think they are fairly similar. But for me, the difference between Deep Impact and Sunday Silence is Deep Impact has a better pedigree, and personally, I honestly believe that his results are better. The other thing about Deep Impact is that he is much easier to handle than Sunday Silence ever was.
As a racehorse, Deep Impact signaled the moment Japanese horses had caught up with the rest of the world. Since his win in the 2006 Japan Cup, no international horse has claimed victory in the race.
But it's Deep Impact surging to the lead. Two champions of the Japanese turf. Taka Yutaka and Deep Impact. Ouija Board closing fast with Dream Passport. Deep Impact losing slightly ground, getting near the fence, but goes on and wins by 3.5.
And if more proof was needed that 2006 was the year Japan had arrived, it came loud and clear on the first Tuesday in November. Coming up, how Japanese horses left an indelible mark on Australia's greatest race.
Starter has them, they're away, and Yates missed the start by a length and a half. Kerry O'Reilly began pretty well. Delta Blues was away well, so was Mandela.
In 2006, Katsumi Yoshida launched a two-pronged assault on the Melbourne Cup. Delta Blues and Pop Rock entered the race after impressive trials in the Caulfield Cup, and while both Japanese visitors were treated with respect, no one expected they would be in another class entirely to the world's best stayers.
Delta Blues in front again from Mandela. 300 left to go. Maybe better coming on. Tipping, battling strongly. Pop Rock joining in. Delta Blues in front of the 200. Pop Rock is danger on the outside. Delta Blues by a length. Pop Rock coming at him. Japan 1-2. Oliver Wills are with. Pop Rock trying to get to Delta Blues. Delta Blues and Pop Rock. They come to the line. Oh, very close. Delta Blues maybe a nose for Pop Rock. Very little between them. Four lengths to maybe better. Delta Blues has won the Melbourne Cup. Japan 1-2.
We took Delta Blues and the Pop Rock to the Melbourne Cup and ran first and second. We took the horses there hoping to win. But to be honest, when we got there, we didn't think we actually would. After winning the race, with all the wonderful shared celebrations and many interviews with the media, we experienced a racing atmosphere that doesn't exist in Japan. I still remember it all very vividly today.
Delta Bliss, Melbourne Cup is, you know, great race existing in kind of another universe. But after Delta Bliss, you know, the Melbourne Cup became one realistic goal for Japanese, you know, owners and trainers.
For Japanese racing, the quinella of the Melbourne Cup put it on the radar of every Australian. I had been competing against them in Hong Kong for years. And I know when the Japanese travel, they're hard to beat. So it was no surprise to me to see those two horses fight out the finish in the Melbourne Cup. They were dominant. Look, there are a lot of people underestimate the Japanese horses. The odds will tell you that. But I certainly didn't, because I'd been working overseas in that region for a long time and I know how good they are.
Delta Blues and the 2006 Melbourne Cup now reside at Northern Horse Park, part of Katsumi Yoshida's enormous breeding operation Northern Farm. Here, Japan's passionate racing fans come to pay tribute to their favourite track stars.
Delta Blues is now enjoying a pension life at the Northern Horse Park, which means, you know, he's sometime in a joint equestrian event. But Northern Horse Park is a horse park open to the public. And racing fans come to Northern Horse Park to see and sometimes touch the Delta Blues. So now Stallion, everybody can remember him.
For all his success on the racetrack, Katsumi Yoshida is equally proud of his horse park and the pleasure it provides the racing public. Northern Farm's paddocks are home to some of the finest broodmares in the world, with over 100 individual Group 1 winners in the broodmare band. Zenya Yoshida left his stallion operation to all three sons, assigning each their own breeding farm. Katsumi and his brothers now compete in the global broodmare market to acquire mares of the highest quality. Gentle Donna is one of the jewels in the crown at Northern Farm. A daughter of Deep Impact, she retired as the world's highest stakes earner. Her victories include the Japan Cup twice, Japan's Triple Crown for fillies, and on the international stage, the Dubai Shima Classic.
Two furlong pole on the home stretch, Gentle Donna with Ryan Moore didn't have a room to go through. At the time, you know, Gentle Donna was ridden by Ryan Moore, maybe the best jockey in the world. Ryan switched the way, then and won the Shima Classic.
Buena Vista is another outstanding race mare well known to Japanese and international race fans. Japan's champion two-year-old filly, she would have won two Japan Cups but was famously denied her first on protest. Classic winners from all over the world have found a home in the Hokkaido snow. Australia's VRC Oaks winner Moshin shares a paddock with Gentle Donna. AJC Derby winner Shamrocker is another to have made the journey north. Redoute's choice mare King's Rose claimed New Zealand's Thousand Guineas, and her first mating with Deep Impact has produced the classy colt Setono Arthur.
The first thing I look at is pedigree, and then the actual mare's results on the track. I believe it is very important for the firm to secure quality broodmares that have won at Group 1 level. There is such a strong presence of Sunday Silence blood in Japan now that without buying good quality broodmares from overseas, the options for covering can be limited. I intend to continue to source and purchase high quality broodmares from all over the world.
Northern Farm's broodmare band exists beyond its own boundaries. A joint venture with Arrowfield Stud has produced stunning results in Australia.
We've produced a number of Group 1 winners, including Weekend Hustler and Sweet Idea, Hot Stetzel, Rianne, a bunch of Group 1 winners. I mean, top-class horses, seriously top-class horses. And it's been a wonderful partnership because we've been able to, each of us, contribute our knowledge, and the bloodstock we have. We provided the stallions, the stallion choices over here, and they provided the mares, and we always discuss things, and out of it we've had these sort of outstanding results.
Heavy investment in the world's best bloodlines is one obvious reason that Japanese horses have become so competitive, but there are many more factors behind their rapid rise. Coming up, the amazing infrastructure and groundbreaking technology being utilised to raise and develop Japanese thoroughbreds. Winters in Hokkaido are cold, bitterly cold. Foals arrive in the depths of these frozen months, a climate that provides an early challenge for Japanese breeders.
Because the weather is pretty tough for the mares, so we have to restrict the exercise and put them into the box, and they are falling in the box. But still they're coming out the same way. So. For us, it's a challenge, but we are trying to make it more natural, both. So, we have to respect the mare foal bond and that type of things. So, trying hard to make it natural in an unnatural situation.
Japanese foals quickly get used to human interaction, as micromanagement processes are required from an early age.
Yeah, we have to always look carefully, so we have to put them into the box every day for even just 1 or 2 hours, and grooming and check the body weight, body height every week. And some horses cannot cope with that coldness, then we have to protect them from the cold stress.
As you know, the climate here in Hokkaido during winter can be very cold. But I don't feel that these cold temperatures and the snow have any negative effects on the horses. We have some horses that are out wintered in the paddocks, and the temperatures at the track work when we are working the horses can be as low as minus 20. Despite these mild temperatures, we do not see any negative effect on the horses' condition. I believe that hot weather can actually be more stressful for them.
Growing up in snow-covered paddocks presents unique problems. Yearlings with so much youthful energy still have to be encouraged to stretch their legs.
Because of the snow, the amount of the exercise is much less if you leave it. When we measure with the GPS, they just walk around in 24 hours, just 7 kilo or 8 kilo, which is in the summertime, they walk more than 20 kilo. We are doing the quite serious training still from the yearling stage. So we'll start breaking in 16, 18 months old and 20 months old. So end of the year and the yearlings, they're already coming up the hill in the 17 per furlong at the type of hill gallop. And we'll never stop the training from yearling to the end of racing. You know, we don't turn out to the paddock.
The training facilities established at Northern Farm are state of the art. There are two long uphill tracks of 1,000 metres and 800 metres, both completely roofed to offer protection from the harsh conditions.
That's a good point for us, having the roof and the hill gallop. The condition of the track is very steady, and we have the time tracking system on the hill. Individual riders have the GPS on the helmet, and the speed and the time is all recorded. And you can see those videos and the time in anywhere in our iPhone for the managers.
There are also three circular tracks with different surfaces to provide perfect pre-training conditions for colts and fillies.
we have to adjust the intensity of the work very precise. So the colts can do more than the fillies. The fillies are more sensitive or fragile in mentally and physically. So that's one of the reasons we are using just a light poi track colts for the fillies and sand or the wood chip colts for the colts.
Northern Farm is also utilising groundbreaking science to ensure the horses are trained to perfection. Blood lactate, heart rate, and oxygen capacity are all measured to assess new training methods.
So I learned a lot about the human side of the sports science. So when I get into this industry, what I think is that we can do lots of things to change the training system in a human way, because horse training hasn't changed for 100 years, but the human training has improved in last 10 or 20 years, totally different.
Experts from around the world visit Northern Farm to lecture staff on the latest techniques. It is fundamental to the Japanese culture to push for innovation.
In Japan, it's getting very competitive, so we have to keep doing something new. That's what we believe. And lucky, working with Katsumi is interesting. He likes new things. And if we ask him to let us do new things, then he never say no. Just try to do it. Individual person's, horsemanship is much less here. We don't have the horse culture here. But instead, we are all, trying to do everything very precise, that type of thing. So it's working.
Coming up, how the richest prize money in world racing fuels Japan's international dominance. Horse racing in Japan is the envy of racing jurisdictions worldwide. The fans are passionate. Many attend the races just to support their favourite horse, and betting turnover remains high.
Yes, the wagering in this country, betting turnover, is, I think, the one of the very best in the world. For example, JRA organised the wagering, simulcasting onto the Arc de Triomphe in France for the first time last year. Wagering in Japan onto Arc de Triomphe was more than double of the wagering in France onto Arc de Triomphe. So I think Japanese likes gambling. Japanese likes to have a bet.
Japanese racing has efficiently capitalized on this love of betting to make their prize money the highest in the world.
In Japan, there is no bookmaker. Bookmaker in this country is illegal. In other words, Japan Racing Association is the organizer, authority of the horse racing, and Japan Racing Association is the organizer of the wagering, which means, once again, wagering in this country is very, very good. All those money coming back to JRA, so JRA can use those, big wagering as a fund for the prize money.
This well-oiled machine is another major reason that Japan's horses are now dominating the world.
Thanks to the good prize money, now we have a good number of the racehorse owners and big number of the shareholders who owns a share of the racehorses through the racing club. So this is, good system for the breeders as well. Good prize money coming back to the breeders. So breeders can reinvestment those money onto another new blood or new facilities. Then another nice sire, good broodmare come to Japan. Then quality of the racing, quality of the Japanese horses come up again. This is good circulation, isn't this?
Another asset of the JRA is its reputation for maintaining a drug-free racing environment and upholding the highest standards of integrity.
I think JRA did a great job to create a good image of the racing. Now everybody understands, you know, racing in Japan is very, very clean. Then, so what JRA did was, you know, they prohibited all trainers or trainer's wife or jockey's wife cannot have a bet onto the racing at all.
The JRA's strict integrity controls also require jockeys to enter a lockdown facility the day before a race. There, they have no phone or internet and can't make any contact with the outside world. A day at the races in Japan is a family-friendly affair. Kids can hit the playground or take a free pony ride, all for just a couple of dollars entry fee. Tokyo Racetrack is home to Japan's Racing Hall of Fame that also provides unique racing experiences. Japan's rise in world standing is clearly demonstrated by its renowned testing ground, the Japan Cup. Once considered a realistic target for international horses, winning the race from overseas is now more like mission impossible.
Look, to go and win the Japan Cup now, I think would be a tall order. You'd have to be a totally dominant Winx, Sunline, Better Loosen Up, you know, a one every 10 years horse. You just couldn't go with a Group 1 winner. I think their depth of horse would be too strong for us. But if ever I get a dominant horse of the year and the quarantine becomes easier, I wouldn't hesitate to go there. It's just a fantastic place.
The Japan Cup may attract the most attention from international fans, but there's another race that dominates the local calendar.
Most popular horse racing in Japan is Arima Kinen. This is kind of the year-end championship race in Japan, usually organized at the same time as a Christmas Day at Nakayama Racecourse. What is unique is the runners of the Arima Kinen are selected through the voting by the racing fans. So fans can select the runners. So usually audience at the Nakayama Racecourse on the day of the Arima Kinen is, last year it was 160,000. Usually audience at the Japan Cup Day is 100,000. Japanese Derby, the same, 100,000. So Arima Kinen is far more popular than Derby and Japan Cup. If you are punters, you have a bet on horse racing once a year. You have a bet on Arima Kinen.
Coming up, a golden era of Japanese racing. We look at the modern day stars who have taken the world by storm. Is another example of Japan's seemingly endless production line of top-rated horses. His devastating win in the 2016 Hong Kong Cup was his third Group 1 success at the famed Sha Tin track. Hong Kong has become a happy hunting ground for Japanese-bred horses. They now strike fear into their opposition at the big international race day.
Everything they do is a very strategic approach. I go to Japan since over 30 years, and I think for me, you see the quality of brood mares, how they buy a especially the Yoshida family, it's for me fascinating. And people underestimate, especially when it comes to 2,000 and 2,400 meter races, the quality of Japanese horses. The Hong Kong International is a showcase for them, and that, I think, will set the stage for them to get even a bigger reputation.
Morris retired after his Hong Kong Cup win and was treated to a uniquely Japanese tradition reserved for their champion horses, a retirement ceremony.
Retiring ceremony was organized at the parade ring, was surrounded by thousands of the racing fans. And they come to Nakayama to join the ceremony. They come to Nakayama to say, thank you, Morris. Thank you and goodbye, Morris. It was a freezing day, very cold day. And after racing, parade ring was surrounded by more than 5,000 people. I think that was a very, very good retiring ceremony.
Morris has now joined the band of super sires at Shaddai Stallion Station, where he will be given every chance of success.
It is all about how we can make Morris a success and sending him quality mares with good pedigree and good race results is our job. I think Gentil Donna is a prime example of this. I think Katsumi will support the success of stallions such as Morris and Duramente with his best mares. You need to send quality to quality.
In a sign of Japan's new role as an exporter of quality bloodstock, Morris will finish the year with a stint serving some of the best mares in Australia at Arrowfield Stud.
Yeah, well, he was just a freak of a horse, you know. We've dubbed him the Beast from the East because he was such an imposing type of animal that was much admired by every racing professional that was there or even was watching on television in that last campaign in Hong Kong. He had speed, he had stamina, he had everything you look for in a stallion. His physique and his performances just obligated us to take him on board and offer him to Australian breeders, and for us to use him, of course. We'll be sending a large number of mares to him.
While the climate will be vastly different, Morris won't feel out of place when he makes the journey to Australia. Joining him on the trip south to Arrowfield Stud will be Mickey Isle and Real Impact, two highly rated sons of the world's hottest sire, Deep Impact.
Historically, when we've identified what we think is a really dominant stallion, we've got in very early and tried to acquire, one way or another, the most effective sons, the best sons. One is Real Impact, who stood here last year for us and will continue, of course, to stand here. And we bought a stake in that horse. And also Mickey Isle, he's a champion sprinter of Japan in 2016. And we're betting that they're going to blend very well with the Redoutes Choice and the Dane Hill family that's out here.
The Deep Impact influence extends beyond the stallion barn at Arrowfield. Just as they did with his father's Sunday Silence, Arrowfield are now sending mares to Japan to be covered by the champion sire.
We sat down and thought about what mares would suit him and what mares were difficult to mate in Australia for lack of proven stallions that were outcrosses for Redoutes Choice, Dane Hill, because that's most of our top mares of that line. And we decided to send Miss Finland over there, which is probably arguably our best mare, Lucky Racky, which is closely related to Redoutes Choice's family, and a bunch of other mares, Star Fashion, Alingi, the champion filly, and now well and truly getting into it as a brood mare. These are the top line mares that we have, and all of them that suited him from a pedigree point of view and from a physical point of view, we shipped over to Japan, and we've got the produce of some of them, and they are magnificent. They're absolutely magnificent. I think we have two colts and all the rest are fillies, and it's going to be very difficult to part with any of them.
It's little wonder Australian breeders are beginning to invest heavily in Japanese horses, given the stunning success they've had in the country's biggest races.
at Mayaraki in the last stride, beat Rising Romance, a photo third.
Hannah's goal, the Japanese mare, has come from well back, has claimed the lead and has rocketed down to the line to beat Weary.
Real Impact and Criterion. Criterion driving here at Real Impact. Oh, it's a close one. Real Impact refused to sit down.
Few parts of the world have escaped the force of Japan's rise to the top of world racing. In Dubai, the world's richest race provided an emotional chapter in Japanese racing folklore, with Victoire Pisa's win in 2011.
To the judge, Victoire Pisa in front and wins for Japan.
That was the year when big earthquake happened in north part of the mainland of Japan, and unfortunately, more than 5,000 people were killed. So earthquake was happened in area of Sendai City. Victoire Pisa was trained at Sendai. The horses, you know, left Japan before the big earthquake. So some of the stable staffs left their family in Sendai. Unfortunately, all those, you know, families are fine, okay. I was there at the Dubai Maiden Race Course, and every Japanese attending there worked like a Team Japan. You know, we have to make every effort to support Japanese horses. I think it was a very emotional moment.
Real Steel is another Japanese horse to fly the flag in Dubai. The son of Deep Impact claimed the 2016 Dubai Turf.
But with 100 metres left to go, it's Real Steel in front. Euro Charlene giving chase. Japan again, Real Steel.
Traditionally, Europe's heavier tracks have caused difficulties for Japanese horses, but another son of Deep Impact, Ashin Hikari, made light of that theory when he stormed to victory in France's prestigious Prix d'Espahan in 2016.
Ashin Hikari, out in front of the Prix d'Espahan, has absolutely annihilated the field. Ashin Hikari wins the d'Espahan from in second place to Ryan.
France, however, is also the location of Japan's greatest frustration. The Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe has become like a holy grail of Japanese racing after a number of heartbreaking defeats, the most famous being Orfevre's dramatic collapse in 2012.
He came in front so easily, but after that he suddenly ran into the, you know, inside fence and beaten by half a length by Solemia. If he, you know, kept running straight, you know, he won easily. But I don't know what he tried to do. Yeah, he has some, you know, strange temperament.
We have been a little bit unlucky in the arc, coming very close a number of times. But I will send horses there every year. It has not yet been won by a Japanese horse, and it is the most famous overseas race in Japan. It is a race that I love to win.
Breeding classic winners remains the priority in Japan. However, the country has also had international success in sprinting distances, with Lord Canaloa winning back-to-back Hong Kong sprints.
But away goes Lord Canaloa. He's going to make it back-to-back wins in the sprint. He's swan song of racing. He's waving to the crowd, Lord Canaloa. Away he goes.
With Lord Canaloa, Orfevre, Victoire Pisa and Morris all joining Deep Impact at Shadeye Stallion Station, the rise in Japanese racing and breeding shows no signs of slowing down.
Well, the Japanese are a brilliant people. We know that they entered the car industry and the electronic industry and were able to get in there from a standing start. Again, here, the Yoshida family, and I deal mainly with Katsumi. I think he's a brilliant operator, and he has essentially concentrated on quality, and they have gone to prove themselves first on the local stage in Japan and then on the international stage. He's been courageous enough to send some of his good horses overseas to compete at the highest level and proved how good the Japanese horses are.
Many people and horses have played a part in raising the Japanese thoroughbred to the global dominant status that we know today. But it was the genius of Zenya Yoshida and his landmark purchase of Sunday Silence that provided the foundation of success.
Sunday Silence is everything to Japanese racing and breeding. He is it. Just like there was a time when Northern Dancer was the horse in the world. Sunday Silence is that for Japan. He has made it what it is today.
Yeah, of course, we are so happy and feel so lucky too. Only one horse changing the whole horse world. So it's amazing.
Just as the Yoshida brothers continued their father's quest to breed the world's best racehorses, Deep Impact is emulating his father's incredible deeds as a sire. Propelled by these remarkable bloodlines and massive investment in infrastructure and technology, the global impact of the Japanese thoroughbred will continue to send lasting tremors around the racing world.